And then there's a change in Winnipeg's net. Laurent Brossoit, he's played his 8 games on the year. He got off to a rocky start in Winnipeg.
Well, they dropped the gloves. Wondered if there'd be some carryover. Apparently the answer, yes. Adam Lowry and Pat Maroon dropped the gloves as the puck hit the ice.
The two big guys going at it. They've got the tie-ups. Lowry a little bit more free with the right hand, able to throw. Maroon trying to get some positioning. Helmets are on, refs. Linesmen are going to let them keep going. And this was discussed right before. Fight right off the bat. We'll see if that doesn't settle things down and they get right to playing hockey.
And that's what John Hines stressed this morning, that we need the win. Goligoski's shot deflected just wide. Spurgeon holds for Minnesota. Boldy comes out of the corner with it. Into the circle for Erickson Ek on the second try. He gets a shot away and a save by Brossoit. Boldy defended by Scheifele. Works through the middle. Boldy gets free into the slot. It slides past Johansson. Spurgeon trying to hold the zone. Erickson Ek with a big hit. Velarde goes reeling to the ice. Then a sharp angle shot. Save Brossoit.
And we'll see if it doesn't do the same this afternoon, because they're going to need all 4 lines and some steady hockey.
Hartman back to Patan. A shot and a save by Brossoit. Mermis has his shot deflected in. On goal. Brossoit able to cover. Aya follow for Scheifele. Out to the line, it's Ehlers. His shot got through and a pad save by Fleury. Erickson Ek cleared, but not past the line. Morrissey into the circle, Ehlers. Ehlers fires, saved by Fleury, and the rebound just got by Velarde. Morrissey across for Toninato, who's wiped out by Bogosian. Back on his feet with a puck. Morrissey centers, a backhander by Barron, and a glove save by Fleury. Fighting with Velarde for the puck along the boards. Morrissey comes up with it for the Jets. Out to center ice. Goligoski one touch back the other way for Hartman. Hartman moves to the slot. Scores! Ryan Hartman extends his goal scoring streak. Minnesota's on in front.
Good hockey. The Wild force an ice from Winnipeg. They haven't been able to break out easy. They try to go cross ice and get a change. Then Hartman goes in. Patan drives to the outside, and that backs off the Jets just enough for Hartman to be able to get this through the triangle. Nice little release.
But it looks like they
are. After review, the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal.
And that's set up the goal. That's how Patan was able to drive inside, push DeMello back.
Spurgeon has it tipped. They score! Marcus Foligno deflects it by Brossoit. He continues to torment the Jets, and it's 1-0 Minnesota.
Well, the Wild are just doing all the little things right now. Good bump from Foligno to not allow the Jets defender to get out to Jared Spurgeon. That creates a little space for him to walk the blue line. He gets the body turned around this puck, and then he's shooting for this tip. Looking for Foligno's forehand. He gets it perfectly. Then Brossoit, a little deep in his net here.
Sandberg plays it down into the Minnesota zone. And the battle won by Winnipeg, but then Bogosian holds his own, and now Niederreiter. 5 goals in his last 5 against the Wild. Drops it back. Appleton, a shot. It's loose. They score. Lowry finds the loose puck. Fleury was looking the other way, and the Jets have tied it.
Well, I think he has to be down on the Wild bench here. It was a bit of an odd entry. Niederreiter had it coming across the blue line. But watch the entry. He goes sideways. Jets drag a foot, and that maybe is enough to keep him onside. Then Lowry just goes to the net and gets a gift on the backhand. Wild just sitting back. Having to receive this, the speed of the Jets. And this one never gets to Marc-André Fleury. Blocked.
Scheifele moves in. Shifley waits, trying to go back to the trailer, and a good defensive play by Patan. Hartman hits the Winnipeg line. Hartman drives the net, and a save by Brossoit. Rossi has it.
Nice little net drive here on DeMello. Kicks that leg out to protect the puck and then tries to bring it to the far side. I think he's trying to chip this one up over the shoulder of Brossoit, but had it gotten through, a little toe drag there to that far side. Nice power move.
Quick shot goes right off the post. 2 minutes. And eventually leads to a Jets power play. Mermis around the boards. Lucchini, one touch for Duhaime. Duhaime racing in. Beats Iafallo, fires, and a save by Brossoit.
Flopping around the net, doesn't know where it is. Mermis kind of kept the puck holstered there. I thought he was going to shoot it. Waits, pump fakes.
Dillon winds and fires. That one hit the post. Next in a 1-1 game. Chips it around the glass. Foligno scoops it up in stride. Foligno hits the Winnipeg line. Across. Now Gaudreau. And a save by Brossoit. He was moving the other direction but got the blocker back to make the stop. Just after the Wild penalty killers keep this game even. And both right now missing one of their most electric offensive players, Kyle Connor, out for Winnipeg. Kirill Kaprizov out for Minnesota. Patan finally wins the battle. Johansson has it. Across, Gaudreau scores!
This is a terrific play from Johansson. Watch everybody from Winnipeg jump out. They're trying to take the one-timer from Faber. He says, hold on, hold on. Don't get it to me. Instead, Johansson looks to that far side. Gaudreau doesn't give up on it. Presents his stick, gets ready. Catch and shoot. Finds a hole in Brossoit.
And now a very important kill for Minnesota. Just after they scored on the power play to reclaim the lead. Perfetti into the corner, Nemestikov. Fires and scores. It takes him just 11 seconds on the power play to answer. And it's 2-2.
And Nemestikov going to school on the Shifley shot earlier. He just wheels over the top. The Wild penalty kill gives him just a little bit of room. Jared Spurgeon maybe not aggressive enough early enough. He comes around the corner, fires this one. Where Shifley tried to.
Delayed call coming against Minnesota. Pionk with it. Back to Dillon, a shot. Tipped out front. Saved by Fleury. Rebound, they score. And it's Toninato who flips it by the Minnesota goaltender with the delayed penalty coming against the Wild, and the Jets have the lead for the first time.
Yeah, Jets are just patient with this in the offensive zone. Dillon up top. He's waiting for a lane. He's got the head up. He sees Toninato alone out front. A little bit of a screen. Throws it there. It hits Toninato. Then drops right at his feet. He's able to chip it on the backhand. Once, twice out of the air. Good hand-eye coordination. And just a little floater over Marc-André Fleury. With six guys, that leaves Mermis and Bogosian to have to make some choices out front. The switch leaves Toninato alone.
Validated it with a start to this season that has him on a pace to go over 70 again. Lowry to Appleton. Bouncing puck out front and a pad save by Fleury. A game-saving stop by the veteran netminder. Down to 22 to play as Spurgeon sends it ahead through center. Spurgeon jumps on the loose puck. Wides, fires, save, Brossoit.
Erickson Ek just beats Dillon, leaving this puck for Jared Spurgeon. Then he walks in, unloads on one. Tries to go far side high, Brossoit.
Puck Boldy centered. Wanted a tip from Rossi. Out to the line, Johansson. Final seconds, a shot. Blocked by Toninato. The rebound for Rossi and then Spurgeon, and neither one can get a shot away. Brossoit and the Jets hang on and beat the Wild for the second day in a row. 3-2 in St. Paul.